With his plot armor, Batman is a superhero who should be considered the most invincible. If this were Image's Invincible, we'd cut to that title card, but it's DC, so we won't. Join me as we revisit Batman's indestructible history and explore some of his most surprisingly death-defying moments. Number 10, Buried Alive. One of the worst ways to go would obviously be to be buried alive. Not only that, but it would be near impossible to escape were this to happen to you. Then again, that wasn't the case for Batman. And he didn't just wake up in a coffin, but he was also strapped into a straitjacket as well. The even more crazy part of this story is the villain who managed to pull off trapping Batman here was kind of just a dude. Not any of his big A-list villains or anything like that. Just a guy with ingenuity named Ed Wiley. While Wiley wouldn't survive the story, Batman would make it out alive. As Superman races against the clock to find and save Batman, by the time he gets there and digs up the coffin that Batman was buried in, Batman has already escaped and is actually standing right behind him. I know it's Batman, but this is all still pretty impressive and insane. Number 9, joining a club. This doesn't sound like an epic death, and I guess it's not really, but it is a really ridiculous one, hence why it's included here. And so, here we go. This one comes from the classic Batman stories of old. In issue 72 of Batman, Bruce hears tell of a new and exclusive club, and so, of course, has to be a member. The club is so exclusive because in order to join, you need to have basically cheated death. Without much hesitation, Bruce scarfs down a poison which will kill him, with the plan to be revived by a doctor, but making it look like the whole thing just happened accidentally. Oh my goodness, I just accidentally ate this poison. The rest of the issue involves him trying to protect his newfound friends of the Death Cheaters Club from a criminal who is denied entry and seeks revenge. Because comics. Also though, I feel like if you wanted to be part of this club and you didn't get in, it's kind of a weird club anyways, so I don't know why you'd be upset, but okay. And friends, before we move on to this next spot, if you are loving this list and you want to hear about more death-defying Batman moments, you know there are a lot more, you know, then be sure to let us know by giving this video a thumbs up. Number 8, Cave-In. At the end of Batman Endgame, both Batman and Joker seemingly die. The two of them are crushed to death, or so it is implied by a cave-in. In reality, they are saved and healed by basically magic science water, referred to as Dionysium. Dionysium has healing properties which allow both the Joker and Batman to survive and be completely removed and healed of their injuries. Unfortunately, they also both seemingly lose their memories as well, effectively giving them a sort of kind of like weird reset. Gotta love when good old magic science water that is connected to the dark multiverse and just happens to be below Gotham saves you. This whole resurrection would also be the spark that would initiate all of the Dark Knight's metal stuff and everything that came after that. Also, if you think Dionysium looks similar to the Lazarus Pits, that's because it's believed to be an ingredient for those immortal and maddening pits. Number 7, Neutron Bomb Explosion. This one comes from Christopher Nolan's Dark Knight franchise. At the end of Dark Knight Rises, Batman seemingly sacrifices himself to save Gotham, moving a giant bomb outside of the city. Initially, they actually hoped to stabilize this bomb, which was made from a fusion reactor core. Unfortunately, that was not in the cards because Talia al Ghul destroys the only chamber in Gotham that they could have used to do so in time. Instead, Batman is forced to therefore fly the bomb out of the city over the water. He gets it far enough away that no one is harmed, other than probably some fish and marine life likely. Guess we just don't care about dropping bombs in the ocean. Aquaman, if he was there, would be like, stop that. The other person that's possibly injured here, of course, is Batman himself, who is implied to be within the craft, or at the very least within the vicinity, to have piloted it. In reality, Batman miraculously survives the explosion and is living happily later with Selina Kyle, aka Catwoman. The two are living abroad for a while and laying low. We never learn how Batman manages to pull this one off though, so I guess he's bomb-proof. I don't know. I don't know how you get out of that. I mean, he could have, the one thing I was thinking is I was like, he could have ejected himself out of the craft at some point. I feel like you'd have to be far away. So I have questions, but I don't have answers for you, I'm sorry. Number 6, Buried Alive Again. In this case, Batman was buried alive during the events of the Batman RIP story arc. Here he seemed to be double-crossed by his lover, Jezebel Jett, who it turned out was actually a secret member of the Black Glove, as well as one of its former victims. Batman ends up captured by the criminal organization and is buried alive by them, but appears to escape with ease. Although at least, as he tells it this time, there is nothing easy about escaping a death trap as deadly as being buried alive. Batman here describes just how improbable and challenging that feat is, but proves that for him, it of course is not impossible. Which really shouldn't surprise us at this point because, well, I mean, he's already proven to be an expert in the matter of this kind of escape before. He's also like a master escape artist, I guess. Still, he gets buried alive a lot. At this point, people should really learn, you know, that's not gonna work for you. Though really, the most amazing feat for me of Batman RIP is that Bruce apparently suspected for some time that Jezebel wasn't what she seemed to be, and had figured out that she was part of the trap before it all came to pass. My question is, I feel like if Bruce is claiming he knew this like from like almost day one, why did this even happen? How did this even get to this point? Alright, you know what, you're Batman, so I'm just gonna be like, okay, Batman. You got it. Batman knows everything. Number 5, becoming brain dead. In issue number 115 of the original Brave and the Bold series, Batman is left brain dead after he's electrocuted by a trap while on a team up with the Atom, where he is trying to solve a case. The Atom knows that while Batman is currently brain dead, he only has hours left before the rest of his organs and his body will completely fail him. Instead of trying to find some way to get some sort of miraculous medical attention, he does what any good friend and colleague would do and decides to help Batman solve his final case. The Atom shrinks down, jumps inside Batman's body, and puppets Batman around from the inside. Sort of like a Weekend at Bernie's style. Fortunately, this somehow fixes Batman's impending death and brain deadness, so not only does the case get solved by Batman, but he's also saved by the Atom's weird machinations. Good job, I guess? I'm glad it all worked out in the end. Love when people are like, you're dead, but also I just jumped around on your organs, so now you're alive again. Yay. Number 4, nuclear explosion. Or at least a nuclear level kryptonite missile explosion. Still, this was a pretty crazy one. In the Justice League Unlimited episode, The Doomsday Sanction, Batman is forced to pursue a missile en route to destroy an entire island, and Superman and Doomsday along with it, who are entangled in a battle with one another on said island. When the missiles from his own craft won't work due to the kryptonite missile having magnetic repulsor shielding, Batman is forced to move the missile with his own ship. He does so and manages to successfully divert it, ejecting an escape pod at the last minute before it explodes. However, the explosion that we see happen is like a nuclear level fiery red mushroom cloud kind. It creates a giant tsunami which hits the island and impacts Batman's escape pod, causing him to lose communication with the rest of the League. Fortunately, he manages to survive somehow. I guess that was one strong escape pod and one strong Batman? Though Bruce is definitely worse for wear by the end of this episode, confined to bed rest and sporting a neck brace when we see him at the end. Number 3, and buried alive again! At this point, I'm like, I need to do a list of all the times that Batman was buried alive, because it happens so frequently. Another time when Bruce was buried alive, it was under a bunch of skulls and bones in the catacombs below Gotham. The Riddler set off explosives that left him buried completely under dirt and bones. While all we're left with at the end of issue 27 is a hand coming up out of the dirt, the following story issue, ish 29 in this case, Bruce seems to find the inner strength to emerge from all that dirt. Although how he's able to get the leverage to pull himself up there, I have no idea. I don't know how that logically would work. Being completely buried in compounded dirt is challenging to get out of without having some kind of help or leverage. Something basically to use to pull yourself out, or hopefully something to pull you out of the dirt. And in this case, he doesn't have any of that. But I guess this is Batman, and so his inner will and his strength, as well as those outer muscles and his sense of determination, is really all he needs. So he's just like, I did it. If there's anything I've learned from Batman, you can do anything if you just focus hard enough and you're determined and you believe. Number 2, dodges Omega Beams. Speaking of things that seem impossible, but if you believe, Bruce might just be a human guy with no superpowers, but he has proven time and time again how indestructible and skilled he is. Like when he faced Darkseid at the end of the Justice League Unlimited animated series. While facing off with the epic villain Darkseid fired his Omega Beams at Batman, the Omega Beam is a power that is notorious for being accurate and just like never missing its target. You may have seen it before and noticed all those sharp angles involved every time Darkseid fires it. That's actually because it moves moves around any objects that are in the way of its target, also chasing said target down until it is hit. Now, in the animated series, however, this wasn't the case, as Batman manages to dodge the beam by basically putting a parademon in its way. This causes the beam to strike and vaporize the parademon, leaving Batman safe. Darkseid is impressed, and I think all of us watching are too, because that's like impossible. "Impressive," Darkseid says. "No one has ever dodged my Omega Beam." That's probably because it's not even possible, Darkseid. And yet. Number 1, Omega Sanction. Maybe one of the craziest things that Bruce has survived was when he took the Omega Sanction straight to the face from Darkseid, or straight to the sides of the head, I guess, more specifically. The Omega Sanction is an unstoppable force, but not for Batman. While Batman was seemingly vaporized in this fight, in reality this was actually a clone, and he himself had survived. Instead, Batman was transported through time and ended up having crazy adventures through time as he attempted to return home. But of course, for a long while, with his charred skeleton present after the fact of his not real death, many of us thought this might be the end this time for Batman. Of course, based on everything that has happened to this man prior that hasn't managed to kill him permanently yet, we maybe should have known better. You can't kill Batman. Not even Darkseid's Omega Sanction can. And Batman apparently in the animated world can just dodge Omega Beams, so he's invincible. Are you constantly amazed at how invincible Bruce is? Or does it leave you unfazed at this point? Would you like to see him remain dead in the comics? Or do you prefer when he constantly manages to somehow survive and return? I personally do really like it when he has cool explanations for how it happened. Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. This has been Top 10 Nerd, and I'm your host, Amanda McKnight, reminding you till next time to stay nerdy, YouTube.